Hi, my name is Bintu and today I'm going to teach you how to display a calendar in Java. It is very difficult to enter dates in Java, and date is a thing that you need many times in every application. For example, you are doing any, say, airline reservation, so you need to enter the date of reservation, the date of flight, whatever. Whether you are doing, say, you are making a shopping cart, you have to enter the date of order, the date of selling. Why the entering of date is so difficult in Java? First thing is that there has to be a format of entering a date. Like in India, the format of entering date is DM and Y. That is day, month and year. In America, what is the format? MD and Y. Month, day and year. In Japan, it is year first, right? So you need to define the format in which the user can enter the date. How about if I display calendar and enabling the user to select month, year and day in the GUI format, graphical user interface, and the date is automatically converted in the format we want? I think that would be a better option, right? So let's do it how it is done in Java, right? I'll be doing everything practically. I'll be using NetBeans IDE for making my Java program, and we all know that NetBeans IDE is a wonderful IDE for making Java programs. When you launch NetBeans, you get this screen. This is the first screen. We'll start with the creating of a new project. You click on file menu, click on new project. Because we are creating a Java desktop application, so you have to select Java from the categories pane. And from here, the projects pane, you have to select Java application. Click on next button. It is asking you to name the new project. Say, let's enter the name as, say, demo date. Leave all these folders intact. These are the text box that are telling you the location where the project will be created on your computer. We don't want to disturb them. Let the project be created at the default locations. Let's click on finish. The NetBeans will automatically create a Java class file for you by name demo-date.java. This is the file that is auto-created for you. At the moment, it is empty. So if you run the project now, you won't get anything in output, right? Because this is a GUI based application, I need to add one JFrame form to this application. So right click on the package, demo date, click on new, select JFrame form. It is asking you to name the new JFrame form. Let's name it like order form. Click on finish. This order form is created for you, and at the moment it is in design mode. There are two modes of this JFrame form. One is source mode, which will show you the Java code. Whatever the control you place it on this JFrame form, NetBeans will create code for you automatically, right? In the swing controls, I want the new calendar control. It is not there. To get that, I have to download one jcalendar.jar file from the net. So I'll open my Google and I'll search for download jcalendar.jar file. Here you can see it. See. Can you see this? This is a link. Let's download this jcalendar.jar file. See, this is downloaded. Unzip this jar file. This is a jar file which is unzipped now. Okay. Now the next step is to include this jar file into our NetBeans. So do one thing. Click on Tools menu. Go to palette option, select this swing AWT components option, you select add from jar button, we'll go to desktop. This is the jar file that is downloaded from the net. Click on next. It is asking you which component out of this jar file you want to include in your palette. There are so many components in this jar file. They are all packed into one jar file. Let's select this JDate chooser component. Next. It is asking you where you want this JDate chooser to appear in your palette. I want it to appear in swing controls palette. Click on finish. See, close this button. Can you see this JDate chooser? This control is auto created for you. Click and drag it over here. I need one button also here, and to display the date that is selected by the user, I need a label control over here, right? I have to increase the fonts of all these three controls. So click and drag and select all the three controls. Go into the font property. Increase the font size to 14, make it OK. So they become visible. I don't want this caption J button 1 to appear on this button. Let's edit this text. Right click on it, click edit text option, make it say show date. Name of this button is J button 1. I want to change it. I want to change the name of this button. So right click on this button, select change variable name, make it say display date. Okay, J button display date, click OK. Next, click and drag this label. I don't want this J label 1 text to appear by default. Right click on it, edit text, and delete this default text. Increase the width of this label. Right, there is a default name for this label, J label 1. Let's change it. Right click on it, select change variable name, make it say show date. Okay, select OK. I want when the user selects this show date button after selecting the date from this calendar, the selected date should appear on this label. So I need to write the code on this show date button. Double click on it. NetBeans will create this method for you by name J button display date action perform. Whatever code you will write over here, whenever the user will click on that button, the code written over here will be automatically executed, right? So we need to write the code over here. This is the code for this. In Java, you need to specify the format in which you want to accept the date, right? So what you're doing, you're making an object by name SDF, it can be any name, of simple date format class. And you're defining the format by which you want to accept the date. It is DMY. You can make it MDY also. What does this DMY represents? D for day, M for month, and Y for year. That means user can enter, user can specify the date in which the day has to be in 2-digit format, month has to be in 2-digit format, and the year can be in 4-digit format. Right? This is the object you created by name SDF of simple date format. The user will select the date from the calendar. The calendar means the J date chooser control, right? So whatever the date which is chosen by the user, you access that. This get date method will access the date which is being chosen by the user from that calendar. Whatever the date that is chosen for by the user, convert that date into the format which is specified while creating this SDF object. That means the chosen date is formatted, is converted into this DMY format and assigned to this string called D. After that, you are displaying that date which is in string format through the label, right? This is the label, right? Let's copy this code and we'll paste it here in NetBeans. It is asking you that it is finding some error here. Why? Because it is not able to understand what is this simple date format. Click over here on the red button. It is asking you to import java.util.local library in this Java application. Click here. Again, it is giving you an error. That means it wants some other library also to be imported in this NetBeans project. Again, click here. It is asking you to import java.text.simpledateformat library also. Click over here. See, the error is gone and you will see that the two libraries are imported over here. Can you see it? The two libraries are imported. This is the code that we copied, right? So let's run this now. To run this project, what you're supposed to do, right click on order form, click on run file option. See, the project is executed. You are displayed this calendar, click here. It is showing you this calendar. You can choose the month from here, any month that you want to. See, I want to book the order for October. Click on October. Year, let it be same. I can change the date. I can change the year also, see. Right? And the day that I want to book is say 17th of October. See. This is a format of calendar, right? The J date chooser format. Now, the moment I click it here, it is converted into the format that I've chosen, DMY. Can you see it? So my application is running perfectly well. If you find any problem, you can mail me at bmharwani@yahoo.com. Thanks for watching the video. Have a nice day.